Well, here's the thing. Here we have a game that is considered a bona fide classic, given an overall 93% in the guide. Quite simply, a Mega Drive classic that shouldn't be missed. And yet, most of the footage you'll see will be me struggling to get past the first screen. Yep, ambling around like a fool, unable to make a simple jump. Now, where is the problem here? With me or the game? This is tricky. I'd say it's probably old man Phil, but I think even back in the day it would have been a bit annoying. Using the old school cliche of World 1-1 for Mario Bros, the opening of the game should ease you in, make it clear what's going on, but there's none of that here. There wasn't anything like that in the game's spiritual predecessor, Another World. But that game was a more interactive, like, Dragon's Lair game, so it made sense. Here it's presented much more as a regular platform adventure game. You don't have that sense of imminent death if you go left rather than right at the wrong time. And it does look a treat. But all that animation gets in its own way. It's not snappy in the way that you want an action platform game to be. The graphics get high marks here, 95%, and they should. For the time, it's a stunner. But you just want to shoot now rather than after Conrad decides to aim the gun. You know what? It's kind of like Total Recall, the Arnie film from 1990. That was like the culmination of analog filmmaking, of animatronics and physical sets and all that. After that film came Terminator 2, then Jurassic Park and computer special effects. In the same way, Flashback is the culmination of that branch of platformers from Prince of Persia to Another World to this. Telling that the sequel, 1995's Fate to Black, was an early third-person 3D game, the medium that would allow cinematic games to flourish. So the question is, do we agree with the 93%? I mean, I think so. This one is a maybe. It's a hard game to come back to thanks to its overly complicated controls, but you can't argue that it certainly stood out at the time and carved its own niche in the video game market. Still, all things considered, I think I would rather have been watching Total Recall.